citations, anything possible to deny it. I mean, part of me was laughing inside and watching this professional eviction lawyer, who by the way, was so nice to tell me that he is human, you know, because people that have to say they're human are, right? But if I'm just allowed to present my case, it'll only be 1 minute, 2 minutes. It shouldn't even, if you look at my answer, and you look at my demands, this never should even be here. The person who, I mean, I'm the defendant. If I'm the defendant, then they're the offendants. Offenders. They're not the plaintiff. They're the offenders. Okay? So, if my case is my answer. I've been told, if you want to listen to this, we'll play a linear truth card game. Everyone gets dealt their Lynn Aaron truth hand. Okay? I got the oral agreement forever, for life. I've been told throughout my life. The one promise has always been from my mom and previously from my grandmother. It's a home for life. This home. 4523 East 3rd. I made a tape of this over a year and a half ago, where I said the same thing. I even said it on it. I said at the end, I go, you know, you gotta be legal with you, right, Mom? And I said the address. They don't want it. Okay, so that's my. That's pretty good first card. And they were, the plaintiff dealt her lawyer an oral agreement to a tenancy of will almost 2 years after I already moved in. That's his card. So, I get my next card. Actually, yeah. Before I move in, my mom hands me the, since I'm not a lawyer, and it's my mom who I believe, where it says, this is Norm Aaron, exclusive use for his lifetime. It doesn't say on there anywhere, you know, there was no small printer somewhere, there was nothing said about, and, there was no asterisk, you know? That's my hand. And then, they didn't get a card. That was it. But then I keep getting cards. I got another card. It's an upgrade from the lifetime free residence to lifetime free residence and eventual owner. And a nice compliment, explaining how nice I take care of the place and how helpful I am. I mean, you know, that's a pretty good hand. They don't even get any more cards. They have a, and then, oh, wait a minute, I get another one. It's a handwritten letter by my mom. Handwritten, okay, that's pretty intent on meaning, and fingerprinted, and witnessed, and fingerprinted, signed. My mom hand delivers this to me. That's my case. Oh, and by the way, this is my home. I've made it. I, I have restrained myself from life, protecting. I'll take my hand. And I know what my mom's intent is and my mom's belief. That's why she gave me these papers, because she did it before. She unjustly, undeservedly has done it before and just was a menace, and she continues to do it. But she did, when she gave me the papers, it's because she knew herself. It was a moment of not of weakness or duress. It was a moment of my mom being a mom for once and doing the right thing. Under no duress. Under no obligation to. Okay? Now I'm done. Now Mr. Bruce whatever can take his USC and whatever, you know, and go on a fallacy filibuster for all I care, okay? I mean, my God, this is just